classic low-output moving coils. You mentioned the getting one with a Riga Elise, and you know, there's something to be said for the good moving magnets in a mid-level price point. I think there are, some of them are really overlooked. But moving to the moving coils, currently Lyra, Dynavector, Hana all make great cartridges that match extremely well. I've been through a ton of different cartridges in my life. Current fascination for me is actually really old Japanese moving coils.
Oh yeah, what did you tell me the other day?
So those need to be restored, retipped usually, and they're never going to be exactly what they were when they were made. But there's kind of a fuller, warmer sound to the bass sometimes. They're not perfect cartridges, but they're really enjoyable to listen to. So the I mentioned the Fidelity Research MC one, which is a real classic, one of the very first moving coils ever made.
Yeah.
Extremely low output. Yeah, and that's just kind of something modern designs maybe have left behind them in favor of accuracy and linearity, which can be exhilarating in its own way, but I think there's something to be said for just the personality that you like and a real fun factor in building your system as well.
So. What cocktail fits with your life this week? What have you been drinking?
Rum. It's hot. But I don't like drinks that are too sweet. I went through a big daiquiri phase earlier in the summer. Currently, it's an interesting one, so I'll just lay it out there. Rum, you could use a white rum, but I like the funky Jamaican rums like Smith & Cross or Appleton.
Yeah, Appleton.
Juice of a lime, half a part of Campari, half a part of Luxardo, and a dash of orange bitters or orange liqueur. And then if it's not sweet enough, a little bit of simple. Shake it and serve it on a couple rocks.